Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can count uppercase, lowercase, digits and spatial symbols available in string with the help of pointers. Before starting, you can note my information. You can follow or subscribe my YouTube channel through the URL youtube.com/sanjaygupta_techschool. You can download my programming app Techimals, which is available on Google Play. Now I am going to implement the solution of this problem. So here I am using strings and pointers together. So first of all, I am including a header file. Now inside main function, first I am declaring a character array, that is str, and a pointer p through which I will be processing this str character array. Now I am declaring some variables c1, c2, C3 and C4. All four variables are initialized with 0. Then with the help of printf, the message enter string will be displayed on console, and the enter string will be stored inside str with the help of getS function. Now I have to assign base address of this character array str in p pointer. So remember that name of array provides base address. So here str is name of array and it is providing base address that will be stored inside p pointer. Now through p pointer I can access all the locations of the character array, that is str. So I am applying a while loop here. The condition is asterisk p not equals to null. So here p is containing base address of the character array. So to receive values, I am using this asterisk symbol. So this asterisk symbol will dereference the pointer and it will provide the values available on a particular address. So if it is not equals to null, then this loop will repeat, otherwise loop will be terminated. Now inside this loop, I have to apply some conditions for checking uppercase, lowercase, digits and spatial symbols. So first condition is asterisk p greater than equals to 65 and asterisk p less than equals to 90. So this condition is for uppercase. If it is true, then the character which is available on the address which is stored inside p, that contains uppercase letter. So I am incrementing c1 by 1. Otherwise I have to check asterisk p for lowercase. So for that purpose I am applying asterisk p greater than equals to 97 and asterisk p less than equals to 122. So this is the ASCII range for lowercase letters. If it is true, then c2 will be incremented. Otherwise asterisk p greater than equals to 48 and asterisk p less than equals to 57. These ASCII values are for digits. If it is true, then c3 will be incremented. If all the conditions are false, then pointer is pointing to the location which is containing any spatial symbol. So this way I have incremented c4. If all the conditions are false, then now after checking these conditions, I have to increase the pointer so that it can point to the next locations of the strings. So this way this loop will be checking all the locations for uppercase, lowercase, digits and spatial symbols. Now after completion of this loop, I can print the calculated results on console. So uppercase equals to %d will be displayed through c1. Now I am copying this printf and I have pasted it 4 times. So second printf will print lowercase through c2 variable. Then third printf will print digits with the help of c3. And fourth printf will print spatial symbols that are stored inside C4, and at last I am writing return 0. So this way all the calculated values which are available into C1, C2, C3 and C4 will be displayed on console using these four printf statements. So this way I have implemented the solution of this problem. Now I am going to execute this code so that you can understand how it is working. So I am entering mixed information So see the output, all are printed as 2. So now check this string. Here capital A and capital T is available. So uppercase letters are printed correctly. Lowercase C and R is available. So lowercase letters are 2. Digits 4 and 3 are available. So digits are 2. And special symbols hash and percent is available. So special symbols are 2. So this way program is working properly. It is properly counting how many uppercase, lowercase, digits and special symbols are available. And processing is done with the help of pointer. So this way I have accessed all the locations of string through pointer. Remember that the pointer is of character type so that it can access all the locations of this character array easily. Because whenever we increase a pointer, it increases according to its data type. So variable and pointer both will be of same type if you are storing address of that variable into a pointer. So this way I have calculated the requirement which is given in the first statement of this program. So I have calculated the requirement of this program through strings and pointers. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can follow or subscribe my YouTube channel through the URL youtube.com/sanjaygupta_techschool. You can download my programming app TechMS, which is available on Google Play. Thank you for watching this video.